The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild is filled to the brim with amazing moments that my mind wanders to on a fairly regular basis. Some of these are scripted, like the powerful memories that show the Hero of Time's last stand against the Guardians from 100 years in the past. Some are more dynamic, like sneaking up on an enemy encampment, noticing a few conveniently placed exploding barrels, and using your fire arrows to blow the whole thing sky high. And then some moments are a nice mixture of the two. The moment I'm going to focus on today falls into that sweet spot. It's been said 1,000 times before that the core premise of the original Legend of Zelda for the NES was inspired by a feeling Shigeru Miyamoto had growing up while exploring the hillside and caves surrounding his childhood home. That perfectly balanced cocktail of danger and potential that only seems to exist when you're young and the possibilities in life are endless. That feeling of wonder over what might lie over the next hill. But it wasn't until 30 years later, with the release of Breath of the Wild, that I truly understood what he was going for. More specifically, it wasn't until the moment I left the game's opening area that Nintendo achieved this pure, unadulterated sense of adventure. The game opens up in an area known as the Great Plateau. It's a relatively large play space filled with ancient ruins, deep lakes, and snowy mountains. You spend the opening hour or two exploring this area, learning the basic rules of the new dynamic world, and solving a handful of shrines that each give you one of the game's core abilities. Upon completion, you're granted access to a paraglider, which allows you to safely float off the plateau and into the greater kingdom of Hyrule below. And so you float, perhaps to the left, in the direction of some crumbled ruins, or maybe to the right, towards a bridge that stretches over a winding river. Or, if you're feeling particularly brave, straight ahead in the direction of a massive castle enveloped by a swirling maelstrom of evil. Regardless of your choice, you can only glide so far before your feet eventually reunite with the ground, and it's here that Breath of the Wild truly delivers on its promise. You have all the tools you need to begin exploring the vast and open depiction of Hyrule. You can go in any direction, and you'll find adventure just waiting to be experienced. There are no locked doors, artificial gates, or story constructs that'll turn you away. If you come across a wall, you can either find a way around it or quite literally climb over it. One of the things that sticks with me most about this moment is that its presentation completely subverts expectations. In any other game, leaving the Great Plateau would have been handled with a cutscene lifted by a swell of music. Effective, sure, but it would have taken control out of your hands and presented the moment in a cinematic manner. But the fact that Breath of the Wild gives you complete control over this descent into Greater Hyrule only strengthens that this is your journey to author as you see fit. There's a melancholic sense of calm to landing on the ground that only heightens this theme of loneliness. Link has been a hero ripped out of time for the past century, but the world around him has continued to move on. The beautiful and vibrant kingdom he once served as protector of is now an ash, and only a few pockets of civilization left scattered among the ruins. There's no fanfare that accompanies the start of your new journey. This moment, and the game as a whole, reminds you that you failed, that the bad guys won, and that there's nothing Link could do to stop it. The only thing you can do is press on into the wild blue yonder and hope to right your wrong. The freedom that accompanies leaving the Great Plateau also represents a turning point for the Legend of Zelda series as a whole. After the wonderfully creative Wind Waker in 2003, the series played it safe with Twilight Princess, which felt very much like Ocarina of Time 2.0. This was followed by Skyward Sword for the Wii, a game with some great ideas and a solid story that were overshadowed by finicky motion controls and a lot of bloat. So for Nintendo to deliver a game in Breath of the Wild that was simultaneously revolutionary while still adhering to the core tenets of the series was nothing short of remarkable. It reestablished a Zelda franchise as one that leads rather than follows. It really does feel like when we look back on the history of open world video games, there will be a line of demarcation between the games that came out before Breath of the Wild and the ones that came out after. Finally, aside from being a momentous occasion for both the individual game as well as the entire series, this promise also acted as a statement from Nintendo itself. After the misfire of the Wii U, Nintendo was in dire need of a win. The Switch's full reveal a few months prior to launch was met with some understandable skepticism. It seemed like a truer expression of what the Wii U was going for, but was that ultimately a good thing? And if the Switch ended up stumbling out of the gates, who knows what the future might have held for Nintendo. But 3 years later, we all know how that turned out. Breath of the Wild would go on to be argued among the Mount Rushmore video game launch titles alongside classics like Tetris, Super Mario 64, and Halo Combat Evolved. This momentum right from the start helped propel Nintendo's hybrid console to massive successes, both commercially as well as critically. The Switch is truly a culmination of what Nintendo has been good at since the 1980s, a combination of warm familiarity and endless potential. I've replayed The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild a half dozen times over the past few years, and I can't help but marvel at just how powerful Leaving the Great Plateau is each and every time. It's a high watermark for Nintendo and the medium as a whole. It's that sensation of adventure distilled into its purest form. In short, it's a moment that turns back time to when you were a child in a world full of possibility, as you wonder what lies just over that next hill.